Hey designer, are you struggling to determine whether you should do a template version website or a custom website? And I know some of you that are not designers that are watching this and wanting to get into website designing or design for yourself. Maybe you have your own small business and you want to build a website and you want to have control over that. And you're going, what do I do? Like, where do I go? I'm here to answer this question for you. My name is Stacey Schilling. I'm a visual design expert. I'm the creator and founder of Stacey Schilling Education Design Hub, and I'm here to help you answer that question. So when it comes to creating a website, and this is brought to my attention because I'm actually tutoring a student right now in Wix. I have a student that was asked by her client to work on a website that was originally built in Wix. The person that had built it prior to her didn't really have a design background. They had more of a coding background. And when the time came to creating this website, the powers that be in the company had told this programmer slash coder to build a website using Wix. So my student that is using the site right now is trying to learn how to navigate the software and go from a print design mindset to a website design mindset on Wix. And she's trying to understand the differences of the desktop version versus the mobile version. So Wix is an example of a template version website. Squarespace, WordPress, those are template version websites, okay? Now, there's a huge difference between template and custom, okay? I'm gonna give it to you very simply, okay? When you think of a template version of website, I want you to think of a Ford Pinto. And if you don't know what a Ford Pinto looks like, I want you to Google Ford Pinto. And you will see a very ugly car that existed in the 70s and the 80s. Ford no longer produces the Pinto, but it was like the bottom of the barrel type of car. I mean, no AC, cassette or A-track tape player, you know, a weird looking trunk, roll down windows, like no bells and whistles. It's like the bare basic of this is what you get. Granted, it got you from point A to point B, but it wasn't anything exciting to look at or to say, oh, I own a Ford Pinto. Like, if you want to say you own a car, you want to say, I own an Aston Martin. Now, when you say, I own an Aston Martin, you're like, I got money. I got all the bells and whistles that comes in that car. It is top of the line luxury. It is amazing. The ride is smooth. It is so expensive that not everybody can go out and purchase that vehicle. But more people could purchase the Ford Pinto when it was being produced because of the cost of it. But there wasn't as much going on for the Ford Pinto as the Aston Martin. That is pretty much the easiest way to describe the difference between template websites and custom websites. And I know you're like, okay, Stacey, two random cars that I know nothing about, so I need to go to google.com and look at Ford Pinto and see a picture of it, and Aston Martin see a picture of it and go, oh, now I understand the difference. So now when you see the difference of the two cars, you'll really understand the difference. Now, here's the easiest way to understand the difference between template and custom, okay? We'll go with custom first because I know everyone wants to hear about custom first. No one wants to hear about template. Custom is just like the name applies. When you say you want a custom design, that means you can dream up anything you want on your site, you can do it, okay? You want animation, you want movies, you want flash, you want tons of videos, you want tons of photos, you want pages that are online that are not linked in the navigation, that are hidden, but only you know how to get them, you can do that. If you want to design it and build it a certain way, you can. Anything and everything that your little heart can dream of having on a website, you can do on a custom site. Now, you might not have all the skill set needed to build that website as a custom website. So for some of the things that you want to do on your website, so if you have this dream and this desire, I am going to build a website as massive and as big as Amazon and compete with Amazon. But I don't want to know anything about coding. I just want to make the layout look great. I want to figure out the organization and navigation. But I don't want to do the physical work of coding it. You're going to need to find a lot of programmers that can do some heavy-duty coding and pay them a lot of money Because I'm going to tell you right now, it's going to be expensive to put a site up as massive as Amazon without the right coders in place to build it, okay? When you're creating a custom website, anything and everything that you can dream of, you can do. So if you are designing a website and you're creating all the pretty side, I like to call it, those pretty elements, the graphics, the colors, everything looks good. So when you go to stacyschilling.com and you see it and you go, oh my God, this site is gorgeous. I love it. I don't care how it works on the back end. It just looks really good. That's when you need to get programmers that can take all those pretty things that you like and do the ugly side and code it out the wazoo so it functions correctly online. Now, with a custom website, the other challenging part with custom website is, aside from having programmers to do your coding, you're gonna have to make sure that it is rendered for mobile devices. And that's not just a cell phone, it also includes a tablet. And it's not just Apple products, it's also non-Apple products. And it's also desktop and laptop computers. So when those programmers and coders are doing all the code for your custom designed website, because you have a certain design and style that you want to create, you're going to have them do all the coding necessary so that way your design is responsive on all the mobile devices. And it doesn't matter what mobile device it is, whether it's a phone or a tablet, whether it's landscape, horizontal, or whatever, doesn't matter. It all has to work. There's a lot of coding that is involved with creating a website, especially custom design. You can do anything your heart can dream about, but you better be having a lot of, you're probably snapping your fingers, what? Money. Money. You need money for a custom design website because you need to be able to afford to hire the right coders and team to do the coding and the programming languages to write them and edit them so they will function the way your site needs to function as well as look pretty the way you've designed it. So that's custom. Now, we're gonna go back to template because you're like, oh, I don't wanna do coding. I don't have that kind of money. Like, I just don't have the money for the Aston Martin. I really don't. But I can afford the Ford Pinto because it's more affordable. And that's great. If you can't afford the Aston Martin, you can only afford the Ford Pinto, that's no problem. So that would be your template design. Now, your template design is gonna be like a cookie cutter, okay? Doesn't matter if you're using WordPress, Wix, Weebly, Squarespace. When you purchase a template, okay, from one of those platforms, it could be even Duda, that's a new platform that's out. Any one of those websites, you're going to purchase a template, okay? There's going to be templates for different industries, for restaurants, for portfolios, for photographers, for wedding events, whatever the case may be that you're designing a website for. There's all these templates. They're pre-made, okay? They've had set text and graphics and images, layouts and designs, okay? When you're using one of those template websites and you're trying to recycle the design that they use and replay it, you know, replug in your graphics, so you're gonna plug and chug, you're gonna pull out all the graphics and plug in yours. Same with the text, you're gonna pull off their text and plug in yours. You might change a couple colors, you might drag and drop information onto the screen or take off the screen. They make it super easy. They make it convenient so you can get in there, build out and design your website and publish it quickly. They don't give you a lot of opportunity to coding unless you know how to code and you have somebody to code for you. If you do have somebody that will allow you to code and knows how to do it, you might have some limitations of what type of coding you can include on the site. When you're building a website using one of these template hosting companies, you're gonna have limitations, okay? You're gonna have to work within those limitations. So if you want to do, for instance, my student wanted to know how to do a rollover on Wix with text. I'm like, you can't do it. They don't give you that option. So she's like, I have to underline my text. I said, yeah. I said, well, for me personally, I hate the underline. So on my website, anything that's a web link is in bold. That just is what I choose to use. So there are things that you can and can't do on a template version website. You also have to not only design it on like the desktop, but also mobile. So one of the things that she's running into is, doesn't matter how the website is designed for desktop, when she looks at the rendering for mobile, it's a hot mess. She's gotta go back in and fix it. And I said, that's because they've designed it because they're expecting people to build this website on desktop. even though when we normally build a custom website, we build the mobile site first because there's so much that has to be rendered and code for mobile before we do the design. It's kind of the opposite of what it used to be. Back in the olden days, in the early, you know, late 90s when we were building websites, we were doing desktop because mobile wasn't around. Now it's been reversed. We're doing mobile first and then desktop. With your templates, you're going to be limited on what you can include within that website package that you have. And in terms of design, you're going to be limited on how many photos you can include or what you can do with them, how things are going to render on pages. That just is the nature of the beast. They've given you control and access to do certain things and make changes and change the layout. Even you can even take a blank document and create a whole new layout design, but you have to understand the software to know how to manipulate it on how it's going to render, not just on desktop but mobile devices. And if you're not experienced in that, it's going to be a really hard process to try to figure out. So my rule of thumb is, before you even sit down to decide, I'm going to do a website on Wix or Weebly or custom, you want to make your wish list. Are you going to have the Aston Martin, which is every single bell and whistle? Or are you going to have the Ford Pinto of what you can afford? You're going to have to figure out what your budget will accommodate and exactly what you actually need to decide, do I really need a custom website or can I live with a template? And if I live with a template, can I make the design work for what I need to work? Because I'm not going to have the money for a custom site for full creative control. You have to think about these things before you design your website. If you want more help with your website or you have questions, you can always go to my website, stacyschilling.com, and click on private lessons, and you can click on 5, 10, or 20 hour private lessons. And we can work together to figure out whether it's better for you to do a custom website or a template website. Or if you're using a custom or template website and you need help with your design and your problem, I can help you with that. Other than that, designer, stay tuned and I will always be able to help you. This is Stacy Designer. Have a great day. Bye.